All right, hi there. I'm going to be teaching you how to do cost projection. This is day five, if you're interested, from our class. This one, you're basically estimating the cost of traveling from Langley to Indianapolis and back. It's a round trip. I've got some basic data, basic formatting here. I added in some assumptions, which for you to know, assumptions are what you're assuming either the price for something is, the amount of, for example, the amount of gas you get, or amount of kilometers you get per tank of gas, how much the hotel nights are going to cost, etc. You're just assuming values so that you can make a general cost projection for the whole trip there and back, so you kind of know about where you're going to land for money. After looking at Google Maps, we have about the driving distance one way in kilometers, 3,804. It's a decent trip. That's, you know, I think we could do it. We're going to do driving. We're not actually going to do flying, so I'm just going to delete that option. So this is not really formatted at all. Before we start, I'm going to do a little bit of formatting. So as you may know, we can do highlighting. So highlighting, you just select the cell, you go up here, click, you pick a color. Personally, I'm always a fan of green. I'm going to go green, and let's make this one a little darker green, actually. Then we can change the text color, make that white, so that that stands out, because that's the title. So now we're going to go back with this one. We're going to make this one a little lighter green, just because I have to put that lighter green in somewhere. I'm going to select all of these cells and add a border to them. Which, if you go up here, you select, you go to this option right here, which I have it selected for a thick box border. You can do all sorts. If you click on the arrow right here, it'll go, you can do bottom, top, left, right, no border. You can do all of these options. I like thick box border because it just kind of shows the whole area and ties it in really nicely. It shows you exactly what you're supposed to be looking for. So I'm going to select that. And now, if you'll notice, there is a very thick black line all the way around here. I am going to start with driving. For a round trip, well, actually, before I do that, I'm going to put a border on this one too, so that it separates it from the options. So click that again. Voila. And then, see this line right here? It kind of looks weird. It's cutting off, so I'm going to go up here. And then I'm going to click bottom border so that it fills in all the way across. There. Now it's more tidy, it just looks a little bit more presentable. So option one, driving. So I'm going to bold this. So if you select the cell, you go up to bold. Kind of gives it a little bit more feel to it. Add in a little bit of basic formatting here, some columns. Just kind of makes it look nicer, you know. That's something you want when you do Excel spreadsheets, because you're presenting information to people, sometimes it's to yourself. If it's two people, you want to convince them of your information, and it's easier to convince them if they like what your spreadsheet looks like. I'm going to bump it all the way over to the right so that it's right up next to this stuff. Alright, so distance driving. So, to figure this out, we're doing round trip. I'm going to edit this right here. Round trip from Langley to Indianapolis. And back. There and back again. Not a hobbit's tale. Alright, so driving. To find the distance driving from Indianapolis, or from Langley to Indianapolis and Indianapolis back to Langley, we already have our one-way distance. So, simple math, all you have to do is multiply this number by 2. There's two options. You could just do in the cell, you could do the formula equals 3804 times 2, and it would do the math for you. Or if you want to use, I don't know, a little bit more formulaic way of doing it, not really formulaic, but kind of a different standard of doing it, you can delete that, and you come over here, you click on the cell. You're going to want to lock this so that when you copy this formula to other cells, it doesn't change where this box is. So to lock this so that whenever you look at this, it always goes straight back to G, what is it, G6? G7 maybe? You click right on there, and then on your keyboard, you click F4. you'll know it's done because you'll see these dollar signs in between. So F4, that refers back to the distance traveled, and then times 2. Enter, and there is our driving distance. That is our total distance that we need to cover. So our time traveling, how many hours it's going to take. Let's see, we have, right there, we have time travel. We can only drive about 8 hours per day. According to Google Maps, because you can't, like, it's hard to do the math with here. According to Google Maps, it will take you, via the speed limits and everything, approximately 3-5 hours to do one way. So we multiply that. I can always add that in here. So let's see, 35. That's that. So driving back here one way. All right. So make that look a little prettier. Oops, that's not how you spell one, is it? So one way, that's the time it's going to take to drive. So now you'll notice here, we made a change. The borders are weird. We just go up here. We click no border. And then we go over here. We click bottom border. Hiding. And then right here in this cell, we go over and we click right border. Now you'll notice that since this line and this line is different, they're slightly shaded different. Oh, we missed one over here. Okay, left border on that. Because they're different sizes, this one's a thick, this one's a thin. Easy way to change that, you go down to here, you go to line style, and you pick your size of border. So, there it is. It is. I haven't really used this pencil feature before, but it's actually kind of useful. You can just kind of color in your sections here. And that's all fixed. Then, it's back. So there you go. Borders are nice and fixed. I don't know why this is blue, but in accordance with our changing, I'm going to make that green and make this black. Looks a little better. Let's unmold that. We don't need a bolt. Alright. Quick bottom border on this to make it a little prettier. And we're off. Alright, so now we have to do time traveling. So one way is approximately 35 hours, so we're going to want to do, let's do the first option like we did, 35 times 2, 70 hours approximately is going to take you to travel there and back, or you could do the option like we did before, where you delete this, you go over here, you click on that, and then you lock the cell by clicking F4, there it is, still 70 hours. So, let's see, cost for gas. How much is gas going to cost? Well, to do that approximately, we're going to use a few different functions and a little bit of math. We're going to use in this one the roundup function. So we're going to go equal sign, and then go round, and then that, and hit tab. If you do that, you hit tab, it'll automatically set it in there. So first, we're going to want to put in the number. So, see, our number for this, I think, is going to be, let's see, maybe distance driving, because cost for gas, it's per kilometer, right? You can do, so we're going to just pick this one, pick this cell, and we're going to divide that by 100, because that is the liters over there, or kilometers per liter. So this divided by 100 times... let's see, all the way over here, we're going to do kilometerage, I don't quite know how to say that, kilometerage, whatever, you're going to do multiply by that, so select that, go lock it, F4, and then we're going to want to multiply that, again, by the gas price, here it is. Multiply by that, lock it again, and then comma, because you still have one more thing. And then round up, what that does is it will round the number that this crazy formula math thing will do. It'll, like when you divide B4 by 100 and then multiply it by G5, multiply it by G4, it'll round that to whichever number you specify. So right here I could specify negative 2, it'll round it down, but I want to round it to 2 digits up. So I'm going to hit 2. Parenthesis, enter. So see, it says 723.2. So that's a number, but it's not really a pretty looking number. It doesn't say dollars or anything. It's just a number. So we want to change that into dollars so we know that that's dollars, not miles, kilometers, or a number of cookies you can eat before you explode. We're going to go up here, we select the cell, and go over here, we're going to click this dollar sign. It will add a dollar sign here so that we know it's more like money. If we want to change how that looks, we can do a bunch of stuff. You can put it into Chinese yen if you're really crazy. Or you can go to currency. I like currency better than accounting. They're a little different, just format-wise. Oops, clicked accounting again. But that puts the dollar sign closer to the money so that it's just a formatting thing. It makes it look different. So there we go. So that is our cost approximately for gas. It's this amount, the kilometerage divided by 100 times 10 times 99. So that's pretty simple, isn't it? Next, we are going to do the cost for parking, airports and hotels. So assuming that parking with hotels is free, we're not going to any airports because we're driving. So we're going to hotels. So most hotels don't charge you for parking because they're charging you an arm and a leg for the room, and never take anything out of the fridge or you'll find that your wallet is quickly empty. So we're just going to put a zero there because we're not going to be parking. So there's zero. Cost for fares, flights, bus, other. You're not taking a bus, you're driving, you're not flying, and you're not bicycling, ferrying, or using roller skates to get there, so we're just going to put a zero here as well. Hotel nights, and this is something different. For hotel nights, this is how many nights you're expecting that it will take to get from Langley to Indianapolis and back, how many days / nights that's going to take, so how many nights you're going to need to stay in a hotel. I'm assuming for this project that we're only going to need one night in Indianapolis. We're going there for some event, let's say a really, really short wedding, and you're just going to need to stay there for a hotel, and then you're coming back first thing next morning. So for this formula, we're going to use Roundup again, because why not? I like Roundup. Equals round up, there we go, parentheses, so let's see, so here's an interesting thing. So we can only drive 8 hours a day. That is what we have decided. We cannot drive 8 hours and 30 minutes because we will fall asleep at the wheel and kill someone, and that is not an acceptable social technique, so don't do that. So we're going to drive exactly 8 hours a day, no more, no less. So judging with that, we have 70 hours of travel time total. So it's pretty easy. All we have to do is do this, our total travel time, lock this number. Oops, not on. So lock that, F4, divided by the time traveling. So divided by that. And I'm probably going to lock this as well. So that will give you more or less exactly how many nights you're going to have. And we don't need it to round anything, so we're just going to put zero there. Parenthesis, enter. So that's going to be about 9 hotel nights. Pretty straightforward. We stay in hotels 9 times. Not my ideal way of doing it. I would definitely tent it the whole way there and the whole way back, because I am a poor college student and cannot afford to drive to Indianapolis and back from Langley. Anyways, cost for lodging. We're going to see how much this costs you. We've estimated that hotel rates is approximately $150 per night. So, with tax included, that's nice. So we're going to take this 150 and we're going to multiply it by 9. So we're just going to do a simple one. 150 times 9. We could do the other way like we did up here, where we multiply this cell by this cell, but I showed you that, so I'm going to do this. And that is approximately $1,350. Which is a lot. That's about almost double the cost for gas, which is strange, because for me, the cost of gas is expensive. Alright, here we go. So, we're now down to total cost for trip. What you're going to want to do... Oh, also, sorry, missed this. Currency. Click that. Go up to accounting, because we want it currency. Put currency. And there, it looks pretty. So what we're going to want to do now is add it all up. We're going to want to add this plus this plus this. We're not going to want to add these in because those are not... Screw that. That's not what I wanted to do either way. We want to add this and this. Look at that. I made a mistake. We don't want to add this, this, or this because those are not dollar amounts. We only want to add the total cost for the trip. So to make that easier for us and avoid what I just did, we are going to bold total cost, bold cost for lodging, bold cost for gas. We're going to basically make it prettier so we don't make as many mistakes. These would be costs, so we're going to bold those as well. And we are going to just italics the rest. So italics, if you don't know, is this I up here. Also control I if you like keyboard shortcuts, which I do. Control I, control I, control I. Alright, so that looks a lot better now. We have the cost bold so that we don't make a mistake and accidentally add the distance driving to our cost, which would significantly up the price. So now, equal sign. We're going to do another function called sum. So sum, and this will basically add whichever cells or numbers we put in it. So we're going to do this one, and why not lock it? And oh, oh actually, yeah, that's what we want to do. We're going to do B11 plus B9, B7 through B9, and then we're going to put another parenthesis in there. And we're going to hit enter. And that is wrong. Why is that wrong? Interesting. Let me just do a comment. Okay, that was my mistake. Okay, so you see what I did there? In the middle of sum, I put a plus. I don't actually know why I did this. It's pretty late and I'm tired. We're going to go with that. But you don't need to do anything like this. You don't need to multiply or subtract anything in here. All you need to do is put a comma. As I should have looked at this, it says number one, comma, number two. So, you get rid of that plus sign, put a comma in, a little bit of space, and then hit enter again. And it adds up this, 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 and this, all into one lovely number, which is about the cost of a class at Trinity, if I'm not mistaken, maybe a little less. So that number is our total cost. So we're going to make this line look pretty by putting this lovely green color on it again. Just for color's sake. If we wanted to, we could do a ton of other stuff here. Like, just for, to show you another thing, let's say we want to do option 2, flying. Hold that really quick. I'm not actually going to find all the numbers for this. I'm just going to put in a number. So, let's see. 9 miles, time traveling, 0.5 of an hour, cost for gas, let's do $5 just in case. Cost for parking, this is going to be a little more expensive, so let's say, $100. Cost for fares, flights, let's say, ideally these days, flights are pretty expensive, so we'll go $1,500, like business class or something. Hotel nights, we only need one because we're flying down there, we're staying in a hotel and we're flying back tonight. So that times that is $150. So those are just some simple numbers. I didn't do any of the math, I just made up these numbers just to show you a different technique of doing things. We're going to add currencies to these, to this, to this currency, and that. So now we're just going to do this sum function. What we could do is we could just rewrite this whole thing all the way over there. But what's easier to do, since none of these are locked, is we take this, we move until our cursor is across, and we click and we drag over. And now instead of adding these ones up, it moves all the boxes over to those ones. See, look at that. Magic. The magic of Excel. There we go. So that's that. Yes, what I was going to show you. Okay, so what I like to do is call conditional formatting. So what you do is you select the cells that you want to format. You go up here to conditional formatting. What this does is it highlights certain cells based on criteria you assign to it. For example, if it's greater than a number, less than a number, between two numbers, all these. So what I like to do is, what do I like to do? Less than, greater than, what I usually like to do here is, I like to use some sort of conditional rule to show which one's higher. So I think we'll go for the greater than. I think that's what I want to do. Yeah, actually, an easier way to show this would be to add in a quick thing for budget. Is, let's say, $1,800. That is your budget for this entire trip. Yeah, that's what you want. We're going to copy this. We're going to put that in a different cell, actually. And it should be right there. Budget. $1,800. Okay, there we are. Double click. Put in a colon. Highlight that. Put a border around it. Thick border, because I like it. And then bold budget. There. A little bit prettier. Could be better. Could move this up. Add it with that. But this is just a temporary thing. I want to show you how to use conditional formatting. So that's our budget. So now we select these two because we want to see which one's in our budget. Go highlight set rules, greater than, and then we click this thing. We click on our cell, which is the budget. Click down, and then it will fill anything, as you can see right here, above it, with a light red fill with dark red text. So as with stoplights, red is bad, and so we don't want to do this option. We want to do this option if this option was cheaper. And then just to stick with the conditional formatting, we want to do highlight cell rules. We're going to do less than. Click on this right there. Click down, and then fill this with green fill with dark green text. Okay, and look at that. It will fill anything that is less than this number green. Green is good. You want green. Green is apples. Well, actually, apples are red. Apples are bad. Green is limes. Limes can be good, especially if in pies. Anyway, I digress. This number is obviously better, so you want to do that. This is basically how you do cost projection using various formulas. This is the estimated cost. We've used borders, currency formatting, assumptions, formulas. I've even showed you a bonus of conditional formatting. And a lot of this over here, this like borders, the colors and stuff, you could probably choose better colors if you wanted to. It's personal preference, really. You can make it prettier by adding this up here. There's always things you can do to make something look better. But to me, this looks all right for a simple cost projection to travel from Langley to Indianapolis and back. Awesome. Thank you very much. We hope you have enjoyed this program. Good luck making your own cost projections. Adios.